Hi, we're at the Shavei Yeshiva in Hebron now. A lot of you have seen on the news the three missing Israeli teenagers and have been very concerned about the situation. So what a better way to help to understand than to be here where one of the students, not all of the students, but one of the students who was kidnapped, and we have one of his friends with us. First of all, we want to say from all the viewers of the program that we are sorry about what's happened. So maybe you can tell us a little bit about Eyal. He's one of the people staying with you, sharing the dormitory that you're in.
Eyal is one of my roommates. We share a room with another 10 guys. Eyal is a very, very strong man. He's only 19, but you can call him a man. He's a guy with his head on his shoulders. He knows what he wants. He's a very giving, caring type of guy. He always comes home with he always comes back to Yeshiva from home with plenty of desserts that his mother made or his grandmother, and he always makes an effort to hand out to everybody. He's strong, not just physically. Physically, he's a strong guy, but mentally also.
And what they were doing isn't something abnormal. Normally, the students hitchhike. In fact, it would have been a hitchhiking place, not here, but on the way to here to get to the yeshiva. Is that right? Or was he going home, or was he coming here?
Eyal, when he was kidnapped, he was on his way home Thursday night. He was kidnapped by terrorists. Hitchhiking is a very common way of travel for us all here. I personally hitchhike home and back to Yeshiva a few times a month. And it was obvious that this was a planned operation to take an innocent boy, three innocent boys actually.
Now, when they left from the yeshiva, did they leave as a group, or he met some friends at the for hitchhiking?
During the actual kidnapping, I'm just like all of us around the world. I have very little details of what actually happened. I know that Eyal was on his way home. He was by himself. I don't know what he was doing myself. The two other boys, Gilad and Naftali, they go to school in a different area, closer to where the kidnapping happened. So I can't really say where or if they were all together, if it happened separately. But I know Eyal came from here, so, and the other two boys were coming from a different school.
And it's not something that is a common occurrence in Israel, because our viewers in the United Kingdom might not, you know, they see the news and they imagine that these things happen all the time, but this is very unusual.
This is the first time that I'm coming to contact with this. I think ever since Gilad Shalit, the captured Israeli soldier who was released so 2 years ago, around. This is the first kidnapping that I'm aware of, or I think that has happened. I know that there have been many failed attempts of kidnapping that the army has thwarted. So
when was the first time that you heard about it? Because this was on Thursday evening, I guess. Did you hear that evening, or was it the next day?
Friday morning, it was made news about the two boys, Gilad and Naftali, that it was feared that they were kidnapped. And we had only heard from Eyal's family that he hadn't made it home that night. And it was only made factual later on Friday, maybe Friday evening, or maybe even Saturday evening that it was clear that he was the third kidnapping.
And what's the feeling here at the yeshiva since the kidnapping?
Like I said before, Ayal, he was a big personality and a loving guy, and when that guy is not around, you feel a lot of pain and a lot of loss, and it's hard to walk into the where we study and not see him sitting at his desk, and walking into the room and not waking him up in the morning, or not hearing his voice. But amongst the guys in yeshiva, this is a unifying moment. This is just as it is around Israel. We feel that this is our job, is only to keep continuing with strength and hope and belief and everything that Ayala also believes in. These terrorists, what they tried to do, it for sure didn't just affect the Ayal and his personal family. This was an attack against the whole Jewish people. And the way the Jewish people have responded to these things, just as we have in the past 3,000 years, is we unite together, and that is evident all around Israel.
And do you have a special message our viewers from the Christian Network and from Revelation Television? Do you have a special message you would like to pass on about how you feel, and just to encourage them about what's happening here?
I think that although we may not share the same beliefs and the same religion and what we call home and what you call home, it may not be the same home, but in the end we are all people with families and friends. And I think when it comes to taking a 19-year-old boy away from his family, from his mother, from his father, from his brothers and sisters and his friends and all the people around him, I think that's a feeling that everyone can feel. And I hope, as all believers in God, that we can count and expect all of our prayers to be answered, and for everyone to stand by the Israeli government in this time, and the army when we try and find these terrorists, and to believe and stay strong like Ayal. And I think to continue with good deeds and love for one another and understanding.
And I know that a lot of our viewers who are watching, and a lot of the viewers watching the television station, will be very supportive of you and very supportive of the situation. Because this is a hot news story, do you have any current information, or is it you just have the information which is that they're missing and presumed to be captive by terrorists?
I would say it's not presumed that they're captured by terrorists. They are captured by terrorists. And unfortunately, I wish I did, but unfortunately I have nothing to report, except that the situation here, for those waiting for Ayat to come home, and Gilad and Naftali, is we're staying strong. We miss them, but at the same time, we're continuing with strength and hope.
Thanks very much for your time.
Thank you.